Hello, my name is Misty Upham. I'm here with my film Frozen River at the Winnipeg Aboriginal Film Festival. And I live in LA, grew up in Seattle, and I've been in the business since I was 13, so about 14 years. And I'm glad to be around all these native artists, filmmakers, and I'm just enjoying my time here in Winnipeg. So thank you for letting me have a cold winter for once. I had to borrow my mom's because I have no winter clothes. I have no winter clothes and spent like the last 3 days in LA looking for gloves.
Misty Upham is here too.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
We walk back the aisle of the sky, handsome girl, which was worth that 6 months to me.
It's a dynamic film. We have Misty Upham. Is Misty here? You probably read about Misty, and she's been helping us out all week. And, you know, it's a film that, you know, speaks to the struggles of Aboriginal women and the things that they find themselves doing to survive in society. So, and that's the thing about the Aboriginal Film Festival, is that that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to look at those issues and at the same time get Aboriginal youth involved in Aboriginal films.
And she just has this amazing story of being in this Oscar-nominated film, and while she was shooting the film, she was working at the Fluff and Fold in LA, and I said, oh, that was before you shot Frozen River, right? She said, no, during. And she also worked at the Fluff and Fold while the Academy Awards were on, so she was telling me that she was folding some man's underwear and then ran home, changed into a $100,000 gown, went to the Academy Awards, and the next morning she was back folding someone else's underwear. So she was making the point this morning to all the kids that this business is not always always glamorous.
I just want to say that I might be unrecognizable in this movie because I put on 65 pounds and shaved my head for it. So this film really is a testament to say that as long as you are dedicated to your art, as long as you're passionate, and as long as everybody does their absolute best, you do not need $1 million to make a great film. And this is, we went to the Oscars. So I just want to encourage you all, you know, don't shoot for the budget, shoot for the quality of the work, and just really give it your best. It's worth it. So I would like to say thank you to Colleen and everybody for having me here. Very excited to represent this film, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
The Grand Jury Prize for Dramatic Film goes to Frozen River, written and directed by Courtney Hunt.
That's my car.
Had the keys in it. I got a friend who might buy that.
About the border patrol?
That's Mohawk land. There's no border.
I'm not taking them across the border. It's a crime.
Let's go!
If the troopers stop us?
They're not going to stop you. You're white.
If you leave, she'll never see your son again.
I didn't know any other way to keep us together.
This film opened doors for me that I still cannot believe to this day. Having Quentin Tarantino as a fan, having people like Ron Howard come up and say how much he loved our little film, it's just been a year of dreams come true, and going to the Oscars and the Indie Spirits. I respect a lot of the people, a lot of the Native actors who've been working for years who haven't had that experience yet. And I feel tremendously grateful and lucky that it's come this early in my life.
When I was 16, I was going to high school in Seattle. And I would get up at 6 o'clock in the morning, take a bus to high school, get there by 7, go to my classes, then do my homework during lunch, get off school about 2:30, get on the bus, do my homework on the bus on the way to theater rehearsal, work until about maybe 9 or 10 in the evening, depending. Then take a bus back home. Get home about maybe 11:30, have time to just eat, quick dinner, shower, go to bed and do it again. And sometimes the only days off I would have were holidays. And it was tiring, but it paid off.
Welcome to Three Nations Indian Reservation, where nothing ever changes and no one ever leaves.
This is like what, a sacred site or something?
This is just a big rock.
Their basketball team has a reputation all its own.
All losers all the time.
Ladies, you just saw the future.
He dares 9 teenage girls to unite as women.
Who does William think he is anyway?
Fight as warriors.
I messed up.
No, you broke your word to me.
And believe in the future and themselves.
You girls are born runners, and we're running teams.
Edge of America.
The Blackfoot believed that dreams foretold the future. We think that dreams shed a little light on the past.
Just the excitement is what I remember. And when I got the part, I was actually driving from Montana to LA, and I just wrapped a film with Benicio del Toro. So it's kind of one of those moments, like Meryl Streep, John Wells, just finished with Benicio. My life's changing.
Could you come here? Whoa. Oh, hello.
Is Jonah the young woman I told you about?
You tell me she's a woman. Woman, woman, whoa, man.
Then I'm hiring.
Ooh. Hire women's now the thing. I thought you meant the other.
To cook one. And to clean, carry you to the clinic.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm sorry. Like this?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, you're very pretty.
Thank you.
Are you an engine?
Yes, ma'am.
What kind?
Cheyenne.
You think I'm pretty? Like this?
Indian in my house.
They're called Native Americans, Mom.
They aren't any more Native than me.
In fact, they are.
Let's call the dinosaurs Native Americans while we're at it.
Yeah, when I watch this film, I'm thinking back on holidays, and I'm like, God, this is so real. It's almost uncomfortable.
I just wanted to thank everybody for your support and for coming. And being around the world and festivals, there's nothing like being around Native people. And being around what I feel like is kind of coming home. And I am not lying when I say that this truly does beat the Oscars. Because the Oscars, I felt so alone, and I felt very much out of the circle. But here, I feel very much appreciated on a grassroots level. And yeah, so this whole week has made me feel like gaining the 65 pounds was worth it. So thank you. Thank you so much. When I get my body back, because it's still not there yet, I'd like to play like the first Native American sultry sex kitten. You know, just a real bad girl, because we'd never really seen that. And I'm sick of people saying Native women aren't sexy. It's like, yeah, we are, but you know, we just don't get a chance to show it because we were always so noble and spiritual and wise and blah, blah, blah. It's like, yeah, we're a couple of, we got some bitches out there, and I'd like to play one of them. My goal from now on is to paint Natives in a modern perspective. Like I said, change the roles and get some sex kittens out there, get some inglorious bastards out there, and play a couple nerds and some rocket scientists and, you know, all that good stuff. That's my goal from now on until I die. Okay, thanks. Bye. I got coffee. I'm going to go watch some movies.